What Adolf Hitler did to millions of Jews through eugenics and sterilization, Planned Parenthood founder Margaret Sanger has dwarfed by pioneering a movement leading to the abortion of over 100 million babies in the United States since the 1920s. Sadly, most people are ignorant of this horrible history, leading to ideas such as population control and euthanasia. Proud promoter of eugenics and racism, Margaret Sanger is celebrated today by most feminists and liberals. So what's the truth behind this dark history? Remember this number. A baby is aborted at a Planned Parenthood facility somewhere in America every 94 seconds. In that same amount of time, Planned Parenthood receives over $1,100 in federal funding. That equals more than 12 taxpayer dollars a second and allows them to abort over 912 lives every day. So how did it get to the point in America where we kill our own and call it a choice? Well, it didn't happen overnight, but an abortion is committed every 94 seconds. We need to look at how this ongoing evil has come to be accepted in a land that used to be considered a Christian nation. In order to do this, it's important to expose Planned Parenthood founder Margaret Sanger's legacy of death and destruction. So we dug up some shocking history of this warped, wicked worldview. Eugenics is the study of or belief in the possibility of improving the qualities of mankind, especially by discouraging reproduction by people who have genetic defects or are presumed to have undesirable traits, or encouraging the reproduction of the fittest, persons presumed to have traits that are positive, desirable traits. Now, hold on to your coffee while we connect some dots here. In her book, The Pivot of Civilization, Margaret Sanger mentioned constructive eugenics, saying, quote, "We are paying for and even submitting to the dictates of an ever-increasing, unceasingly spawning class of human beings who should never have been born at all," end quote. Sanger's publication, The Birth Control Review, was founded in 1917, and through the years, she often published articles from socialists and eugenicists such as Ernst Rudin. Who? Ernst Rudin was a psychiatrist who worked as Adolf Hitler's director of genetic sterilization and founded the Nazi Society for Racial Hygiene, which was Germany's racial purity program. According to her own autobiography, Margaret Sanger spoke to the women's auxiliary of the Ku Klux Klan in Silver Lake, New Jersey in 1926. Just 3 years later, American Birth Control League laid the groundwork for her first abortion clinic, where? In Harlem. Sanger argued for compulsory sterilization and segregation for people with disabilities. In 1932, Margaret Sanger published A Plan for Peace in the April issue of her Birth Control Review. Here's just a part of her agenda. Quote, "The first step would be thus to control the intake and output of morons, mental defectives, epileptics. The second step would be to take an inventory of the secondary group, such as illiterates, paupers, unemployables, criminals, prostitutes, dope fiends, classify them in special departments under government medical protection, and segregate them on farms and open spaces as long as necessary." End quote. That same year, Ernst Rudin's article, Eugenic Sterilization, An Urgent Need, was also published in Sanger's Birth Control Review Journal. Now, after World War II had concluded, the horrors of eugenics, concentration camps, human experimentation, and the gas chamber were all exposed. So Margaret Sanger acted quickly and deceptively to distance herself from the Third Reich's final solution. Her idea to change the name of her Birth Control League, aka Birth Control Federation, was shrewd, and the organization became Planned Parenthood Federation. Until 1942, birth control and eugenics were nearly impossible to separate. Prior to World War II, Sanger was outspoken about her views on race and used the influence of prominent New York blacks to further her cause. Sanger reiterated the need for the black minister to head up the project in a letter to Clarence Gamble in December 1939. Listen to this.
In concluding this portion of the letter, she stated that we do not want word to go out that we want to exterminate the Negro population. And the minister is the man who can straighten out that idea if it ever occurs to any of their more rebellious members.
Wow. Is it a coincidence nearly 80% of Planned Parenthood clinics are in minority communities today? Sanger worked closely with William Edward Burkhart Dubois, co-founder of the NAACP, on the Negro Project, and invited other prominent black leaders to be advisors and help limit births in the Harlem community. Now, the Bible teaches about God creating life. Psalm 139, 13 through 16 states, "For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful. My frame was not hidden from you when I was made. Your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be." Now, Margaret Sanger taught that the campaign for abortion is, quote, "practically identical with the final aim of eugenics," end quote. In 1934, she suggested that only parents approved by government or eugenics leaders be allowed to have children, and that a strict code be enforced to stop the overproduction of children. Sanger reasoned that by requiring a license for mothers to give birth, it would protect society from those who are unfit. Part of her American Baby Code included Article 4, "No woman shall have the legal right to bear a child, and no man shall have the right to become a father without a permit for parenthood." Article 5, "Permits for parenthood shall be issued upon application, providing the parents are financially able to support the expected child, have the qualifications needed for the proper rearing of the child, and have no transmissible diseases. Article 6, "No permit for parenthood shall be valid for more than one birth." One only needs to look to China for the disastrous consequences of its enforcement of an awful totalitarian one-child policy. But the rotten fruit of Margaret Sanger has already brought decades of destruction and the devaluing of human life. Which brings us to today. Please pray for hearts to change. And it must start with true believers in Christ. Church leaders need to boldly speak up because this is a matter of life and death. We must also elect conservative, pro-life, and family-friendly representatives to local and state legislatures. And by the way, Pastor John MacArthur stated, quote, "If you're a Christian, you cannot vote for a person or party that slays babies in the womb," end quote. Think about that the next time you head to the polls. I'm David Fiorazo. God bless you, and keep speaking the truth about things that matter.